Now, let me take this opportunity to introduce our first speaker for the day, Mr. G.K. Pillai. Sir, may I have your permission to begin, please? Thank you, sir. Sir is presently the Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer of the Vulchand Industries and is an acclaimed management leader and a well-known name in both the public sector and the private industries. Graduating from BITS Pilani in the year 1973, Sir started his professional career in the field of control valves with instrumentation in Palakkad, Kerala, as a graduate engineer trainee and worked there till 1994, where he held the position of Deputy General Manager. Thereafter, he ventured into the private sector and was with a US joint venture, Fisher Senmel Limited at Chennai, where he rose to become the Chief Executive. He was also the chief executive for Tyco Senmar at Chennai. After working for 12 years, Sir took over the reins of Heavy Engineering Corporation HEC Limited, Ranchi, a scheduled A public sector of the Government of India in May 2007 as the chairman and managing director. The company was going through very difficult phase, almost on the verge of closure. However, with some very innovative management initiative, Sir steered the company out of the red, and since then the company has been making profit. Under his leadership, HEC has come back to the national and international limelight and has been successful in forging strategic alliances and making specialized equipments for the mining, steel, nuclear and space sector.
Seeing the excellent turnaround he brought about at HEC, with effect from January 2011, Government of India entrusted him with an additional responsibility of Chairman and Managing Director of HMT Machine Tools Limited, another ailing PSU. After superannuating from both these organizations on 31st December 2011, Sir joined one of India's most famous engineering groups, Vulchand Nagar Industries Limited, where he is at present the Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer. Sir has been a recipient of various awards and recognitions throughout. Some of them are awarded Scope Excellent Award for the year 2007-2008 from the Honorable Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh on 15th October 2009. Indian Nuclear Society Award for Industrial Excellence in January 2010. Bestowed with the Outstanding Contribution of the Industry Award by the National Industrial Conclave 2010. Awarded a Scroll of Honor by the National HRD Network in April 2010. Awarded the BRPSE Turnaround Award. Bestowed with Leadership Award from the Asia Pacific HR Congress in Bangalore in September 2010. Awarded the Performance Excellence Award by Indian Institution of Industrial Engineering on 15th June 2012 at Udaipur. Awarded the Engineer of the Year Award by the Institution of Engineers, India, Palakkad, Kerala Chapter on 15th September 2013. He is also a keen speaker and has delivered talks on various national and international platforms and also to educational and training institutes all over the country. With this, may I request Sir to please come and share his words of wisdom with us.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
I think it's a small hall, so am I audible to the last, or is it? Yeah. First of all, I was just thinking, when I was invited by your director to come and talk to the young, budding management experts whom you're going to become tomorrow. So, and he says this is the new batch. So I said, how? So I was just thinking, what do I talk to you? I should talk something which you will love to listen. I don't want you to go back, get bored. So I was just thinking, how do I put across what you would love to listen, not what I would love to say. So let me try. As they say in Hindi, Aupcharikta. I'm not sure about your institute, whether you allow to speak in Hindi in between, yes or no, but I will take the liberty of using some words because it becomes more easier for me sometimes to communicate. Though you may think that he's a man from Kerala, how he's more conversant with Hindi rather. Anyway, that's a different story. So let me finish the Aupcharikta, which is very important. What is Aupcharikta? Absolutely, you're right. Formalities. Okay? And that is important. I'll again tell you why it is important and why it is more important for people like you who are gathered in this room. If you are not the management graduates, how many of you are engineers in this room, having an engineering background? Very few. Very few. What are the other, any commerce, how many commerce graduates? Oh my God. That's very good. So you have made my answer a little bit more easier. Because had it been engineering subject or engineering people, they don't have Aupcharikta. Aap kisi, you know, you go to any scooter workshop or a car mechanic, he doesn't have formality. You take a bike and if a kaam nahi karaya, he will immediately start, theek hai, nahi theek hai karke. But whereas when you go to a shop, you go to buy a new car, you go to a showroom, that person will be very, hello sir, how are you ma'am, all those things will be there. So Aupcharikta is more needed at certain area. So here also, let me complete my Aupcharikta. Okay. Honestly, I am very proud that I have been invited in this, your great institute, Indus School of Management. I had the privilege of coming even earlier, on earlier occasions. But it's good to come, and I really am very happy that here is an institute, when you come, you find the smell of discipline, the smell of commitment, right from the day, right from the time you enter the campus. And when I see this gathering, my conviction about the way this institute is run becomes a little bit more stronger. I had the privilege of attending many of the management institutes in and around Pune, and let me tell you, you have come to perhaps one of the best management institutes in Pune. So you can feel yourself that you have done a right decision of coming to a place which will really turn around you. They say, no, makeover karte hai na, there was a talk about makeover some years back. Shakal hi badal dete hai. You don't even know how that person was looking earlier and how he or she is changed. And I am sure the next 2 years will become, you will be really made, a total changeover will happen for you. Getting college education is still low. And getting management education is very, very few people have the privilege of getting management education in a good institute. So ladies and gentlemen, you should think that you are privileged. You are one of the few people in this country. Why have you decided to pursue a course in management? Basically because obviously everybody wants to earn money. Nobody says earn money. If anybody says I don't want to earn money, then he is telling the first lie in the morning. Okay? So everybody wants to make money. Everybody wants to have a good life. All those things are well accepted. But what is more important is you with your management education will be able to take India, like we have reached the fifth position, maybe tomorrow the fourth position, maybe tomorrow the second position, maybe tomorrow, day after tomorrow the first position. Now this is one of the important aspects of your, you may think, oh, I am one MBA, how am I going to make an effect? You will be making an effect because it's all of you together. Want something, you can really make it happen. So that is one part. Second point which is very important is, I think all of you should really be grateful to your parents. I am telling you with all sincerity. You may come, you may attend the class, you may do things, you may get degree, you may go out, but you do not know, or even if you know, it may be in your heart that your parents would have done a lot of sacrifice to get you admitted in an institute like this. Education doesn't come very cheap these days. It's an expensive proposition. Your parents would have done real lot of sacrifice. So one thing which you should keep it in mind, that their sacrifice has to be rewarded. They don't want money when you come out of that. I don't think any parent is looking at the money. What you have to make yourself successful and make your parents proud that my son, my daughter has really contributed to the country, to the organization, to herself or himself. Keep this in mind for the next 2 years, because somebody somewhere is waiting far off. Which are all states you are from? How many are from Maharashtra? How many from Pune? Only two from Pune. That's very good. It's a good. Which are all the states? Jharkhand. Bengal, good. Orissa, I'm sure nobody will be there from my state. Kerala, see. maybe the Keralites don't go for management, could be that, I don't know. Or they don't come so far away, I don't know. Anyway, so, good. Now let's come back to what you would like to know in the next 40 minutes or so. Did you ever realize what does the industry or the organization, when they look at you, what do they want you? You know, you should also know, if you are going to an MNC, if you are going to an engineering industry, if you are going to a unit like a big bazaar to work, or you are going to a startups, or you are going to a companies like a Uber or a Ola, what do they want? You see, the demand is changing. Some years back, if you talk to your in your house that I am going to spend so much money, I did my engineering, I did my this, and then I did my MBA, and I am going and joining a company called Uber, you know what your parents would tell? Ru taxi wali kar, tum kya tum taxi chalane wale ho kya? Unka manager banne wale ho? I am telling you, that will be the right thought process what they may have. But you know, all of us know, that whether it's a Uber, whether it's a Flipkart, whether it's any of those companies, the organization which needs management graduates are changing. There is a time it was only companies like General Electric or some of these banks, some of the financial institutions. I'm talking 15, 20 years back, when the management graduates are invariably going to those institutes. Do you know, can you just find out, or can you just tell me, assuming after today is 2018, July 12th, assume it is 2020, somewhere in June, July, and you have completed your 2 years program, you have groomed yourself well, all those things happen, and companies are coming to interview you. Do you know what do they look at it? What do they look? Can anybody feel? Because you should know that what the prospective employer is looking at. Can you just anybody tell me what they may be looking at? Yeah. The mic person should be doubly running. Yeah.
Good morning, sir. My name is Nikul Upadhyay and I am from Indore. When we complete our course, the industry person, corporate person wants us to be incredulous. They want a right attitude from us, that any job they will give, we are ready to do it. They don't want us to be skillful and specialist in any job, but they want the right attitudes from us, that they will, when they will make us train, we will ready to be trained and do any work they would want.
Okay. Okay, good. Okay. When an employer comes, an employer looks at the attitude, employer looks at the passion, the employer looks at the commitment of the person, okay, sincerity, knowledge. Somebody said he does not, you don't have to be an expert in the knowledge. No. Let me tell you one thing. I still remember, I passed out, I did my engineering from 1968 vintage, 50 years over since I joined engineering college, to 1973. And every college has its emblem or slogan. Do you know what is the emblem of your college? What does it say? Does it say? Does it say anything? Oh, it's here only. So, let knowledge prevail. So, somebody did mention about knowledge is not important. Your emblem itself says. In my college, the emblem had, Bits Pilani, Jnanam Paramam Balam. Knowledge is power supreme. Okay, knowledge is power supreme. Without knowledge, you can't do anything. Is that adage valid today? Is it valid today? Yes or no?
Thank you so much, sir, for your thoughtful guidance. Unsuccessful people are always asking, what's my share in profit? And successful people are always looking for opportunities to help others.
With this, we have a quick break of 5 minutes. Be back soon.
Supreme thing. Why? Knowledge is essential. Knowledge is very important. But today what is important is, listen carefully, application of knowledge. You may have knowledge, but if you do not apply the knowledge correctly, the application of knowledge is more important than knowledge. So, it changes. It changes. You know that there will be from, you have a knowledge, very clear knowledge from here to go to Pune railway station, it takes 45 minutes. You also know that because of monsoon, there is this road is bad, that road is bad, something is there. So, what do? You know, if you do not apply the knowledge what you have, that there is a road blockage is there or something else is there, if you don't take 45 minutes or 50 minutes for your plan, you will not reach the destination. You may. Time is available, is the same time for you. It is not 24 hours for you and 20 hours for me. It's all 24 hours exactly for all of us. Okay. What is the only differentiation in this all? That one M, that is the men. It's men and women both, huh? So don't feel it is men. It is actually the human. Just for the sake, it had been put MMM. So ultimately what happens is, in an organization, however good the organization may be there, however same technologically competent you and your competitor are there, it is the people who run the organization are the one which is most critical for the success of that organization. So keep it in mind that next 2 years you have to see to it that you as an individual is the most important asset in any organization. Money is an asset, machines are an asset, materials are an asset. All those things are there, equally important. But a differentiation which can happen is only you. So don't think my value, are in this huge organization of 15,000. No, you can do wonders. So we were discussing what the interviewer looks at a people when they do the interview. They think that the individual should be working, should be having the passion to think that this company belongs to me. And if you start doing that, I can tell you, if you start doing that, you will really be successful and the organization will also be giving you growth opportunities. What do the people expect from you? There is an engineer, the gentleman who said he is an engineer. He goes to the company and they expect certain output from him. The same person, once he completes his management education, the expectations are different. The expectations from the organization is different. When, what's your name? Rohan. You are the one engineer, you said, no? When Rohan comes to a organization with his, today if he joins, people look him as an engineer. If Rohan joined the same organization after 2 years, they think that he has done a management education and the expectation differs. Expectation goes up. What does the organization expect? In 2 years, his foundation is engineering, mind you. But, or your foundation is commerce. What does the organization expect? And this is true for all, whether you are a BCom, whether you are a BSc, whether you are a BPharm. They expect you as a management student, a management graduate, will deliver a higher level of output to the organization. How is the higher level? One of the things which everybody expects you to do is do a analytical. Analytics is one of the strongest points for management graduates. The organization expects that you will be experts in making analytics, making analysis, both. That is an important point. Your decisions will be based on data. You work on data. You are expected to work on data. No hunch. Management graduates are not supposed to work on hunch. You know, that is sometimes, you know, tukka lag gaya. It should be based on data, proven data, realistic data. So the organization will actually expect you to bring in a higher level of information. The third point which you are supposed to do, which you will have to really look at it, is strategy. People will expect, organizations will expect you to be experts in strategy. If you do not strategize how the things will happen, then your business will actually fall down. So you as management graduates are supposed to work on the data, based on the data, strategize what should happen to the company, what the organization should do, maybe after 1 year, 2 years, 5 years, etc., etc. So strategy becomes another very important point, as I explained about analytics. All the next 2 years, an excellent stay. Assimilate as much possible. Do not think that, you know, I have learned sufficiently. Learning is a continuous process. After 2 years, step into the world of competitive life. It will be a competitive life, like you have today in class also, you have competitive life. Your life in professional world is competitive itself. And never dream small, dream big. All of you should really think, I'll just add one line and then I'll close. When a person joins army, when any officer joins army, you know what is his ambition? To be the general. If a batch of 300 or 400 of army officers join, all 400 wants has an ambition to be the general. Only one become out of that general. Okay, that also they know. Only one will become out of that general. 399 will not become generals. But the ambition should be there that I should be that number one. And you should all think, wherever you are there, you should think of aspiring to be number one. With these words, once again, thank you very much. Thanks to a lot for giving me this opportunity to come and meet all of you, and wish you all good luck. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you so much, sir, for your thoughtful guidance.